The embattled politician announced his decision to step down before his colleagues expelled him. They had the votes, and Senator Kittner says he knew it. He feels his resignation prevented lawmakers from setting the dangerous precedent senators can kick people out they don't like.
I think it sets a very bad precedent, and I think my stepping aside saved them from themselves.
What were you thinking when you made that retweet? What were the reasons?
You know, I just looked at it, I go, boy, that's kind of interesting. Those women are pretty profane. And they're out there protesting and they're acting like that. That's pretty profane. We'll throw it out there and see what people say.
Did you ever think it would become, as you call it, a stick to beat you with?
Absolutely not. I would never have done it. Going back, I would not put it out there. That's asking for trouble to do something like that.
Did you ever consider that tweet would be making light of sexual assault like some of your colleagues here took it?
No. And if I finally had this to put a statement out saying I do not condone sexual assault in any way, shape, or form, and I'm going to pull that down. If there's any, people are misconstruing that. They were taking it as that.
Senator Kittner says he's not the first lawmaker to make mistakes, only the first threatened with expulsion.
We've had people get DUIs when I've been here. We've had people get their girlfriend pregnant. We've had people fornicate with staff. We've had people cheat on their wife. That's between them and their constituents. I've never said a word.
It's his belief the battle following his bad decisions boils down to politics.
I've been standing in the way of a lot of things the progressive left wants to do. So if they can knock me out, not only is a major roadblock out of their way, but it sends a signal to the other conservatives, shut up, sit down, keep your mouth shut, or you're going to get the Kittner treatment.
Nebraska Democratic Party leader Jane Klebs seemed to confirm his reasoning with a tweet this morning. The Women's March just took down their first politician. Senator Kittner says he's at peace with his mistakes and asked for forgiveness.
I said, I did it. I'm not going to fight it. I signed an agreement saying I did it. I signed, I'll pay the fine. Once I did that, I had more peace than I've had. I just was totally at peace. And I think my wife is at peace and our marriage is strong. And I got to tell you, it's good to meet me.
Are you going to continue tweeting?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I don't have my account up right now, but at some point I'll put it up.
Senator Kittner says he's confident the governor will replace him with another conservative lawmaker, a consideration that he says helped him make the decision to resign. Julie, back to you.
Okay, thanks, Dave.